And welcome back to F1 Manager 22 with Williams, the original staff. As you can see, we are 9 points behind Alfa Romeo, 16 behind Alpine for 4th, following Alex's win at Singapore, 2nd win of the season. We almost had a double podium, but Jack crashed with literally just like 2 or 3 laps to go in the race. If Jack hadn't crashed, we would probably be, we would have passed Alfa Romeo. And probably would just be a few points behind Alpine. Alex is 15 points behind Valtteri. If he can win one or two more races, he may be able to catch George for 6th place in the points. Carlos Sainz lead Leclerc by 4 points now with 5 races to go. Perez is 62 back. Max is 82 back. Lewis Hamilton is almost eliminated. He's pretty much eliminated from the points, being 114 back with 5 races to go. He literally has to have everyone in front of him have problems. 114 behind Carlos Sainz, 110 behind Leclerc. He would literally have to have both Ferraris pretty much not finish the rest of the season, and he would have to win all 5 races. Max and Sergio still have a shot, but if they don't start doing something soon, they're running out of time. If we can keep scoring pretty decent points, we should easily finish 4th in the points in the first season. That would be unreal. And we're heading to Japan. And then we have Japan, Canada, Mexico. And in Mexico, we have a front wing design coming. And that will be the last design we have is coming in Brazil, and it's an underfloor design. But after the front wing design in Mexico, we will research a front wing and hopefully be able to get 2 research. 2 front wing researches done before the end of the year. After this race, Jack will receive another development point. And we're going to put it on control because he's had 2 races where he should have had really good finishes and crashed out. Ferrari leads Red Bull by 140 points. Ferrari has almost wrapped up the Constructor's title. Mercedes is 270 back. Mercedes cannot win the Constructor's, so. The beginning of the season, it did not look like we had a chance in hell of finishing better than 8th, 9th. We needed to score four of the final five races. Let's head on to the practice session in Japan. I don't know why I was going to say in Mexico. Everyone's sure to be keeping a close eye on Alexander Albon, who took first place in last Grand Prix. Even more eyes on Leclerc, who will be sure to fight with everything to claim the first place spot this time around. Yeah, I agree with that. Being only 4 points behind Carlos. Man, it's a cloudy race. Car analysis. That shit. Ferrari, they're not the best. Well, let's see. Nope, they're not the best car overall. Maybe not. No, Sergio Perez and Red Bull is probably the best car overall. Mercedes. They're a little bit better than us in the medium speed corner. We are better than them in the high speed corner. McLaren, we are better than McLaren at pretty much everything. Quite a bit better than McLaren. Alpine, they are better than us at high speed cornering. Damn it. That hurts. We are better than Haas, better than AlphaTauri, better than Alfa Romeo at the medium and high speed corners. So we should be able to finish better than Alfa Romeo. And we're easily better than Aston Martin. So 2, 4, 6, 8. 10. So we should easily finish in the top 10. Should. I'm going to say both guys make it to third round of qualifying. Finish top 15 with one driver. Only have a few months left and we have to re-sign Alex. Probably gonna replace Jack Aiken. replace Jack Aiken with maybe Lieutenant Sergeant. Or maybe Frederick Westy. We'll make a decision later on. In Japan, practice, here we go.
Konnichiwa from the Suzuka Circuit in Japan. This unique track is a favorite home for motorsports, and it welcomes us back this weekend. Get ready for exhilaration and speed with the Japanese Grand Prix. Drivers will battle it out this weekend on the snaking turns of Suzuka, the only figure of eight track in Formula One. High-speed downforce will be the name of the game here, if teams want to secure a place on that podium. This is it. We're down to the last few races of the season, and it's time for that final push. Who will be crowned champion at the end of it all? We'll find out soon enough. Let's get this underway.
Isn't it exciting? Right now, with five races to go, it's a four-point lead for Carlos Sainz. That's it. This could come be a very exciting finish to the season. Two kilograms of fuel per lap. Wow. Wow, I may have to buy a new ERS for Alex. I hope not, but and I may have to buy a new gearbox for Jack. And Alex, god dang. Yeah, but that don't look too bad. Well, yeah, well, let's give that a shot for Alex. Twenty percent, 23%. Hell with it. What's the race strategy? Soft, medium. Okay. So we need to keep two things of soft tires. If we can keep two fresh soft tires, we could be okay. Performance, the mediums are not much difference than the softs. Half a tenth? Wow. There's Jack set up for the first practice session.
Radio check.
Copy, radio check.
That's green knot. Green knot.
Alex is gonna get held up. Yeah, Alex gets held up quite a bit actually. Let the first practice run up. Finish up. Zach's first practice run is almost over.
Back on the cut.
53% for Jack, not bad. Not bad to start the practice run off. Alex will have to run at least one more lap. That's not too shabby. That's not too bad. Two laps on the medium tires. Alright.
Yellow ahead.
Okay.
I think we've had a car run wide.
All okay.
Car feels okay.
Copy.
Look, 14 and then on Alex's rear wing. The optimal traction. That's a 3.10. Let's try 3.10 for now. Send Alex back out on the medium tires. 30 laps. We computer set up and send them both back out immediately.
Who's running wide there?
Perez runs wide. And Jack is off and running with his second practice run. Is out on his second practice run.
Let's have a look. Now we see the Williams here. They're forced wide.
Well, that wouldn't be bad. And this is a sit back and wait game now. This should get us to the end of the practice session. Or almost the end of the practice session. we should be able to come in one more time, reconfigure the setup, send them back out with just a few minutes remaining, maybe 5-10 minutes remaining.
Oh, did someone run wide there?
Verstappen, everyone is running wide today.
When you have it, give me feedback on
Man
balance.
Jack's setup is perfect. Wow. Jack does not have to come in again. Will Alex have to come in again? If I can do it in the first practice session, oh, 72%. I was going to say if I could have done it in the first practice session, the last two practice sessions would have been AI. Okay, so 13.5. That should be pretty good for Alex. That should be. Who knows? So we ran 13 laps.
Okay,
we ran
end of session.
20 laps easy on the medium tires. Okay. George Russell, Pierre Gasly, Kevin Magnussen taking a penalty. Tires on, 49 laps. Let's put 35 for now. Yeah. Second practice session.
Radio check.
And Alex on out.
Radio check.
Because Jack's practice is done. He does not have to actually run a lap again, but. Drivers have ran their qualifying lap. Come on, Alex. Be at 100%, buddy. Neutral, neutral.
Had a car run wide.
Alex runs wide.
That sounds like someone's gone wide there.
Alex, 95%. Okay. Good enough. It's either going to go up or down. Alex Lee would be closer to 100% or closer to 90%. Go ahead and bring Jack back in now.
Entering the pit lane.
Copy. Watch out, one line and pick it up.
And send Jack out. Let's go 14 laps. Qualifying run on soft tires.
Someone's run wide.
Come on, Alex. And Alex is 100%. Thank God. Alex will get at least one on the soft tires. We won't have to run the third session of practice. We let the AI take care of it.
Sound okay?
No, I'm happy.
All right, Roger.
Okay, we are happy to push.
Copy.
Jack out for his final run, final lap.
Our race weekend continues as we head into FP3 and then qualifying. Yep. Drivers will need to perform with remarkable consistency if they're to secure a strong position on tomorrow's grid. It's not just about one moment of brilliance. No, they'll need to prove over the course of qualifying that they have what it takes to occupy those coveted places. You're going to want to join us for this, folks, so fasten your seatbelts.
Third practice session is starting. We'll let the AI take care of it. I'm gonna switch out the gearbox for this gearbox. Yeah, this is destroyed too, but I don't want to use that one in practice. Third practice session is over. Both drivers are in really good position. Go ahead and switch out the engines for both drivers for the better engine. The better ERS and the better gearbox. Before we do the qualifying. And we want to definitely try to keep two sets of fresh soft tires if we can. There you go, round one of qualifying. Should be one lap, we should be good.
Radio check.
Copy, radio check.
That's green now, green now.
Alex and Zach are in great shape. Leclerc, yeah, both drivers are in. Second round of qualifying. After just one qualifying lap. So we'll go out on the used set first. Second round of qualifying.
Radio check. You hear me okay?
Copy. Radio check.
And both drivers are off and running. Yeah, Alex. He's good. Runs a great time. Zach kind of struggles. Damn it, I don't know what to do. What, do I send Alex out in front of Jack? Why not? Why not? And Zach goes 5th fastest, Alex is 7th fastest. We should be okay now. And we have both drivers make the 3rd round of qualifying. and keep jack two sets of soft tires or take him on two medium sets of tires. Round of qualifying. Yeah, I'll send Alex out first since Alex has got the fresh set of tires. Maybe he can pull his jack around.
Ready to check.
Oh, Jack's gonna get stuck. Goes seventh fastest. He's only a tenth of a second behind Alonso. Just over 2/10 behind Hamilton. The top four are within 2/10 of a second of each other. Send Jack out on a fresh set of soft tires. Jack does not go any faster. Well, he goes faster, but he does not pick up. Oh my gosh, 1/1000th of a second from 9th. And Alex qualifies 8th, but he will start 7th. Jack will start 9th. So we qualify really good again.
It's time for the final touches here on the grid ahead of today's race.
Qualifying went well for Williams, as attested by their strong position on the grid. Now it's all about finding that edge for the race itself. Alfa Romeo managed to meet expectations during qualifying, and if they can keep this up, they'll have a good race ahead of them. And the sun is shining bright here today. This is perfect weather for teams and drivers alike to show us what they're capable of.
But now it's time for the team's cunning to emerge and for the driver's talent to shine. Let's see what's in store for us at the Japanese Grand Prix.
Okay. What set up to use? 124 even, 124, 123.56. $23.55 for Jack. $23.55 medium. Medium to hard. All right. We're at 21, like, we're at 25. Alex on lap 26. Alright. And as I set up, reset up. Practice and qualifying sessions over with. When we come back, we'll be racing in Japan. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, click the bell, comment. When we come back, it will be race time in Japan. We'll see you then.